welcome to another episode of Frightfully Forgotten Horror Movies. And before we get started, what are we drinking today, Adam?
Today we are drinking Dragon of the Black Pool Black Lager. If you want the recipe, click the link above our heads.
Today we're going to bring a weird and wacky movie to you. It is 1986's Crawlspace. David Schmoller wrote and directed this. He did one of my favorite horror movies, Tourist Trap.
Yes.
I really love that movie. And he did Puppet Master. Klaus Kinski is in this. He was in that remake Nosferatu movie. Yeah. Talia Balsam, she plays like the main female lead in this. She was in like a lot of TV. One of the big ones was Mad Men.
So Crawlspace starts off like any good horror movie should.
Yeah.
Unnamed female looking through this attic comes across this person in this cage.
It's all
shines a light over and sees these jars with all these body parts in them and everything. Turns around. It's a shame. I really liked you. Then some weird mechanism thing is, impales her from the back. It's a great opening scene because number one, it's a good kill. It keeps you wanting more. Like, oh, what's this about? Who's this person in this cage? This weird old guy at a kitchen table by himself with this gun. Puts his blood kind of on the bullet. Starts playing Russian roulette. Then it shows this kind of woman getting changed.
She all snips the nipple
parts
off.
Yeah, it's so bizarre, eh? Yeah.
Why would you ruin a perfectly good bra? Like,
he's all in the duct system, like crawling through the ducts.
Yeah, and her boyfriend is outside leering in at her.
Yeah, and then he comes in and they end up like having sex, looking in on them and everything. It turns out that Klaus Kinski's character, Dr. Guenther, is like the landlord or owner of this apartment building. This very 80s gentleman comes inquiring about the room and it's been rented. Close the door. And right behind him is a good-looking young woman and she comes up inquiring about the apartment and it's available suddenly. You're very beautiful.
Yeah.
The look in his eyes and his demeanor is like just so off-putting. Contemplating the apartment. She's got her back turned. He turns on the stove and it's
this flame.
Flame stove.
Up.
And he puts his hand over the flame and he can see it's burning. And he's like, you take it. Oh, yes, I'll take it. All girls, of course, live in this apartment, having a dinner together. And he sets these kind of rats out through these tunnels with these trap doors and these pulley systems and everything.
Some little trap door comes up.
The rat comes out and he torments the girls as they're having their dinner. He's eating some chocolate bar and he's reading that book.
Yeah, here's the knock, and it takes him forever to answer the door, but finally he does, and this guy's like, I finally found you. You know, I've been searching for you. And it turns out that Dr. Guenther ended up killing this guy's brother when he was a doctor in Buenos Aires. So this guy's after him. Dr. Guenther's dad was part of the Einsatz group in World War II. Dr. Guenther continued the work, I guess. Threatens to get him taken away, put in jail. And rigs up some chair with like a spike through it. And they're like on the on the arms of the chair is like the buttons to activate the spike. Through the seat of the chair.
Up his ass.
Yeah, up into him, yeah. Watching these Nazi propaganda films and like putting makeup on and like lipstick.
Just smearing it on.
Lori comes home and she opens up the fridge and the fridge is covered in rats. But she goes into the bathroom. He's floating in the tub. She tries to leave the building too and some cage thing comes and stops her. And they end up dueling it out. In the attic and in the ducts of this apartment building. That dolly
system gliding down the ducts. This movie is very artsy, but it's also just as fun.
Just from the opening scene alone.
Yeah.
This movie sets the tone.
Grips you right in.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Right from the opening scene, you know that Mr. Guenther is the killer.
Yeah.
There's no mystery. That's out of the way. Now you just get to watch him be a weirdo throughout the whole movie.
They gave you just enough, they inched you along enough to be perplexed enough to want to watch the rest of the movie. But it's very simple, too, right?
Well, like, yeah, it's very simple.
The way it's done, it's almost point form, really. Yeah. They don't get too bogged down in the characters in the building either, right? Nope. You see just enough to, okay, you get a sense that they're fun party girls and stuff. Also, I love the fact that it takes place in this one building. There's only a few scenes that they show. It's the attic, the ducts, and a couple of the rooms.
If there was a scene that took place really outside the apartment, it would take you out of the movie completely. And I love the fact it's just all the whole thing right in the apartment.
Yeah, you feel claustrophobic at times too.
Yeah. The dialogue is hilarious. She keeps calling him the wrong name, which is funny. She tells this guy that she reminds her of her old rotten uncle.
Yeah, like, oh, that's nice.
That's great. Like, if I was with a girl, you're like my old rotten uncle. Oh, yeah, I'm very turned on now.
Yeah, come on, baby.
It's just such a great scene. This movie is so 80s, but in a good way, not in a bad way. It's in a very reflective way. I like the way The Fly is 80s. Well, 80s old mullet.
It reminds me of Ricardo Montalban. Con, like, he's a very tragic character, right? He writes in his diary that he's addicted to killing.
I think the Russian roulette scene is left up to your own interpretation. What does that mean?
Yeah, like, I think it means that he's
trying to punish himself.
Yeah, he wants to end it. He doesn't really enjoy killing, but he has to keep killing.
Or he enjoys it, but he feels bad that he enjoys it, almost.
Right, so he's punishing himself. Yeah.
Like, I love the backstory for Dr. Guenther. I think it's a very cool backstory. Nazi and hiding stories always been kind of neat.
That's true horror.
It's real. That has happened in real life. Mm-hmm. There's these Nazis that were out there who escaped that were hiding in America, and people would actually, try to find them out. So it could be a real story.
Yeah.
The music for this movie is great. Like, it's right from the get-go. It grips you in. It complements every scene perfectly. Another great thing about this movie is the lighting. It worked so well through the Venetian blinds.
Right.
The shadows and everything. It's just so creepy. And when he's in the ducts, again, the same thing. There's those lines always kind of across his face as he's peering through. The projection of the Nazi propaganda, always projecting these weird shadows on him. It creates the atmosphere.
Klaus Kinski's perfect for the role, too. He was a bit of an asshole on set, though, right?
Bit of an asshole. I think more than an asshole.
Everybody wanted to kill him, basically. And that's where there's a documentary that's called Please Kill Mr. Kinski. He's lucky he walked out of there alive.
Apparently, Klaus Kinski isn't a big fan of directors. I watched all these interviews with Klaus Kinski, and he's like, this guy is fucked. He's just a weird person. Another cool thing about this movie is all the weird devices that Dr. Guenther uses to kill his victims.
Yeah, it's like a hallmark of this movie. They're macabre.
They're macabre. You can tell there's a lot of thought put into them, and it's almost like he makes someone else trigger it themselves, where he's not actually the person doing the killing, right?
Yeah.
It's very akin to, like, almost like The Collector, almost.
Yeah. This movie is a lot like People Under the Stairs, The Collector.
Yeah.
You get a little bit of, like, Buffalo Bill in there.
And we love those movies, so that's why we like Crawlspace.
Yeah.
Yeah, a movie with, like, a really good antagonist and this kind of claustrophobic house that you must escape. You'll like Crawlspace for sure.
Yeah, definitely check it out.
Until next time, keep drinking.